Namaskar. I am Mahesh Kulkarni from Swatantravir Savarkar Rashtriya Smarak and Swatantravir Savarkar Mountaineering Club. In month of August 2018, I have completed my bike trek in Himalayas, and I want to share my experience with you. So here I will tell you my experiences, as well as I want to give certain guidelines if you are planning first time for this Himalaya section. I have visited the Himalayan section, that is in state of Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh. I have started my journey from Chandigarh by bike. From Chandigarh we went to Pathankot, from Pathankot to Srinagar, from that to Dras, then Kargil, then Lamayuru, Leh. From Leh we visited Nubra Valley, from that Pangong Lake, then again Leh, and from Leh we went to Manali, and Manali to Chandigarh. This was total my journey in Himalayan section. I want to discuss this question wise. Now first question, what is the path we followed? I am showing you that path in map, but this map is not proportional map, not according to scale and not that accurate. This is just to show the area or the way we traveled. So here this is the map. You can observe Jammu and Kashmir state, parts of Himachal. So here this is Chandigarh. We started our journey from Chandigarh. From Chandigarh we went to place here that is called as Pathankot. From Pathankot, Pathankot was our first halt. Then second halt, that was at Jawahar Tunnel. From Jawahar Tunnel we travelled towards Srinagar, but we were not having halt at Srinagar. We have halt at Dras. So this way now we climb here in Ladakh section. This is called as Dras. From Dras there is Kargil, Lamayuru. We have another halt at Lamayuru. Then Leh. Another halt was at Leh. At Leh we have to take permissions. That is called as inner line permit. And then after that we started here and went to Diskit. From Diskit we went to Turtuk. That is, we can say here, westmost point. Again returned back to Diskit, and then we started journey towards Pangong Lake. So this journey is very nice. From Pangong Lake we returned back to Karu. From Karu we returned back to Leh and take halt again. Again from Leh we started journey towards southwards and have had halt at Pang. From Pang we were having halt at Kelong. From Kelong we returned to Manali, and from Manali we returned to Chandigarh. This was the path totally we followed in this section. This is no doubt just to give you idea. Line art is there. It is not at all perfect map. Otherwise we have to shift this map little bit towards road, towards northern side. Now what things we have to carry with us? Number one, we have to take your own medicines, and from where you are carrying out journey we have to take your medicines from that place only. Don't be under impression that we will get medicines on the way somewhere else, because many times this happens, that what I personally experienced. I am from Mumbai, so I personally experienced that some medicines having different names in Mumbai, whereas different brand names, say chemical content may be same but brand names are different in this region. So carry out your own medicine from Mumbai only. Then we have to select proper season so that we can take needy things accordingly. The first thing, that selection of season. So we travelled this in month of August. Mid of August we started our journey, and therefore the season was summer season in this area. So no much protection was required. So we should carry out blankets and all that. So like that, things are not required here during month of August in this all trek. So that is the important thing that we can carry out with us. And what is the most important thing? That you should have knowledge of the area. Maps should be there with you. This is bike journey, and therefore some important tools, that spanner and all that should be there with you. Preferably, I will advise you to have bike with tubeless tire, so you can carry out some pump and puncture kit also with you, because if tire is having tube, then it is difficult to clear out from puncture. But tubeless tires are good, and a little bit mechanical knowledge, because what I observed personally here, that telephone network is not that much good. So various companies, obviously you should aware that when we are there in Jammu and Kashmir, only postpaid connections are working, prepaid connections are not working, and then also all networks are not available. Very selective networks are there. When we visited, there was only network of BSNL in the inside land, but at some places Airtel network was also there. But again, keep in mind, network is there from village to village or city to city. In between that, vacant areas are there and no networks are there. And so it is advisable that you have to carry out some important tools regarding your bike. Obviously, a helmet and other protective material is essential. So this is the thing I am going to advise you regarding what you are going to carry. Obviously, this is a general thing. If you are carrying out trek in month of May or June, then there is winter season yet not cleared out here, and therefore you have to take precaution that gumboots and all that things are essential in this month. So it is according to what you are going to do, which season you are going to select. We selected it is dead after mid of August, and therefore no much heat was, no much cold was there, and so our journey was of something different level. We took minimum material with us, and that's why our journey was comparatively easy. You can check out here my bike and what the material I am carrying out on my bike. That's all. Which bike we have to select? The thing is that in Manali or in Leh also, bike on rent are available. Many people carry their own bike. Say, I come across various people from Kerala, they traveled on bike. From Maharashtra, they traveled on bike and went there. Some of our friends were on bicycle, not on bike. So this is the way people are traveling over here. I came across 2-3 groups. Out of that, one group was there from Maharashtra. From Maharashtra, they traveled by bicycle from Pune to Dras. We have a meeting at Dras. Anyway, but which bike you can select? That is obvious. My suggestion is that you have to take bike which is under your full control. Say for example, I am using my bike. I am habituated with that bike, so I carry out my bike. I travelled from Mumbai to Chandigarh by train. That bike was taken from Mumbai to Chandigarh, and from Chandigarh onwards we started our journey. As that bike was my own bike, two advantages I got. Number one, that no need to get adjusted with new bike over there, the first thing. And second, as our bike is there, whatever expenditure we are doing on it, that is there with us. Say for example, you can get their bike at rent of suppose 1500 rupees per day. So if you are using it for 10 days, you have to spend 15,000 rupees. But by this way, if I am carrying my own bike, then I adjusted some stand, that is a carrier like thing, then tubeless tires, new tires we use, all these things. But ultimately that things are there with me. And therefore, my suggestion is that please try to carry your own bike. Now the question is that whether certain bikes are required. Many people suggest that, okay, we have to go in Himalayan and you have to go by bullets only, either 500cc or 350cc. So it is not required. I traveled this entire Himalayan section with my Honda Livo bike, which is just 110cc. And I was able to travel it comfortably. I'm not saying that some problems were there and all that. No, it's very nicely I was able to travel in all this section. The reasons, number one, my bike is lightweight. And number two, lightweight means as compared to other bikes, it is definitely lightweight. And another thing is there that I was used with that bike. For 2 years I was driving that bike, and now that bike only I took there. And so that is the advantage. And obviously one more advantage is there that I must notify you that when we are having lower cc bike, they are giving very good average. So I was getting some 55 km per liter average over there. And that's why we should not carry out petrol with us and all that. Otherwise, there are comparatively less number of petrol pumps. And if you are using higher cc bike, then petrol tanks are not sufficient. And petrol pumps are also not there distributed as in urban areas. And therefore, we have to carry our own petrol. So when you are using this type of lower cc bike, the advantage is that we should not carry petrol with us. Whatever the petrol is there in tank, that is sufficient. Impact of climatic conditions on yourself as well as your vehicle. Okay, this is important thing. When you are going at high altitude area, there is lowering of pressure. Atmospheric pressure lowers down. Those who are science student or those who are aware, they are aware that when barometer we are using, for every 160 meter altitude rise, barometric pressure decreases by 1 mm of mercury. This way, when you are going height about 3000 meters, obviously atmospheric pressure will decrease to considerable strength. Again, as we are rising higher the altitude, amount of oxygen in air also decreases. These two major things are there we have to take into consideration. And then there is concept we are using that as acclimatization. That is important. Now when I followed this particular path, Pathankot we can consider almost around 200 meter altitude. But Jawahar Tunnel is comparatively very high altitude, around 3000 meter. Then Dras, around 3500 meter. Then Lamayuru, around 3200 meter. Leh, around 3500 meter. So from Jawahar Tunnel onwards, we used to stay at high altitude. So while reaching at Leh, almost for 3 to 4 days, we used to travel around altitude of 3500 meter on this Leh to Kargil road. Kargil to Leh road or Srinagar to Leh road, certain paths are there. They are of altitude more than 4000 meter high. And therefore, already some sort of high altitude approach was there. And therefore, we were not having problem of high altitude to that extent. Keep in mind, we were not carrying out any mountain climbing physically. We traveled completely throughout my bike. And therefore, it is not the thing that climbing and all things we perform. But still, we got somewhat acclimatization at Jawahar Tunnel onwards. And as we were driving with bike, and that is also, my bike was of 110cc, we were not able to climb up very fastly. And that's why that helped us a lot of the way. That acclimatization problem was the problem of that climate was not that much having impact on us, because our march was slowly. So this is actually difference between using high cc bike and low cc bike. When you are using high cc bike, obviously your speed is comparatively better. For lower cc bike, no doubt I am saying that I traveled nicely, but I was not able to climb up with very high speed and all that. Sometime even problems were there, especially when we traveled around Khar Dunda. There, that when we were approaching 4000 meter plus altitude, sometime we feel that okay, our bike is on second gear and I had to take it on first gear, but actually it was on first gear. So like that experiences we were having. Some effect of pressure, that lowering of pressure is there on your bike also. The most important visible effect is that if you check out pressure in the tire, you'll find always it is going to higher end. The thing is that you are getting at high altitude, external pressure is lower and therefore internal pressure increases. And many times we got that pressure in range of 50 or 60 plus also. So time to time we have to check pressure when opportunity is there. And from Srinagar onwards, we were just removing out air from tire till Diskit Valley. We carried out the same thing. Diskit Valley is comparatively at lower altitude and there we had to fill air. But till that, this is the impact. Even the fizzy drinks, cold drinks, they are more fizzy in this area. Whereas even some packed food, when airtight packets are there, you'll find that they are expanding to their maximum level. So this is impact on other things also of lowering of pressure. So lowering of pressure is having some impact on your vehicle as well as yourself also. But practically speaking, in our tour, we were not facing out this type of problem. Maybe possible we visited in summer season. In winter season, already demand of oxygen from our body is more because we have to get warmer. And then the impact of lowering of oxygen is to the great extent in winter season. But as we visited in summer season, this type of problems were not arrived. Even the most important thing I want to tell, till almost altitude of 4500 meter, that means at Khar Dungla road, I was traveling with my half shirt, full pant and ordinary chappal in my foot. I was not using shoes till that portion. Then onwards also, I was able to travel with only wind shifter next journey. But no shoes were there in my foot till we reach to Pangong Lake area. So this is the way. Cold climate was not there, particularly from 15th of August to 31st of August. And so this season, I recommend you that ideally, if you want to observe nicely, then go in this season. If you want to test your hardship, then go in winter season. Road conditions in Leh region or that entire Himalayan region, what roads we observe. We are talking about that. First, we have to give lots of thanks to Indian Army because our journey to this area is safe and possible because of Indian Army only. Secondly, BRO, that Border Road Organization, that is also obviously part of Indian Army only, but they maintained and they prepared very good roads in this area. What I observed, that road conditions are very, very nice. When I travel from Srinagar to Leh, with fewer exceptions, obviously this is mountain area and we can't express always super express highway over here. But with fewer exceptions, road was very nice. It's complete tar road and two trucks can pass out at a time easily from that. So suppose some truck is coming from front side, you should not decrease your speed and take your vehicle to side, maybe possible take halt. Like that condition was not there throughout the road, except there is a pass that is called as Zo Ji La, that is between Sonmark to Dras. This path is this pass is there. Some 20 kilometer road at that position was not good. It was under construction. So obviously, I am saying that, okay, this year, that means in 2018, road was not good in this particular patch. But you may expect that in next season, at 2019, this path may be cleared out, and this is also, you can observe, tar road. But road constructions were going on at every point. I observed that whenever the problems are there, at that problematic part, we observed that, okay, next year, we will not get this type of problem. Even I observed some videos of Khar before going to Khar. They were old videos. Their road was not that broad. But now when I visited, I observed that road is comparatively broad and nicely maintained. Only last patch of Khar, around say 10 kilometers patch, that was not tar road, but everywhere work was going on. So again I am saying that when you visit this next year, that means in 2019, you may get good road over this part also. So except with this type, the road conditions, that was very nice. Now certain problems on that road that we have to take care. Say for example, if you are traveling from Diskit to Pangong Lake, I am showing you the map again. This is Diskit and this is Pangong Lake. So this journey from Diskit to Pangong Lake, not by Leh. So two ways are possible. You have to come back to Leh, Karu, and then go to Diskit. Then go to Pangong Lake. Or travel directly by this road. So this road was under construction when we went there. But it is also nicely broad and all that. But certain points were considered as risky points there. The thing is that hills are there, obviously Himalaya is there, Karakoram ranges are there, and there is melting of ice or glaciers at top of hill. That water comes down and at some point they are breaking out road. So you will find a very good tar road, then break, and then again very good tar road. But some 30-40 meter distance you have to travel through that river bed, or whatever the water coming out of glacier, through that bed we have to travel. And then it is advisable that manage your time in such a way that you should be there before 11 o'clock morning. The reason is that as afternoon is there, there is melting of ice to great extent, and water level at this riverbed increases, and you are not able to cross out that riverbed. But if you are going before that, then obviously water level is less and you can travel by your bike through this. Now here, when you are using a lightweight bike, the advantage is that you can pass out through this glacier patch easily. Because say that 30-40 meters patch is there where you will observe only boulders, and through boulders you have to drive your bike. And that is, if heavy bike is there, you have to make more efforts. If lightweight bike is there, you can take comparatively with very good control. Check out that water is not going through the silencer. So we have to check out level. Now what first we achieved, that first we get it down from bike, we cross it manually, checked out the level of water, and then we went through the that glacier water directly. On sitting on bike only we travel, but it is not that risky. Because we travelled it before 11 o'clock, and for that purpose sometime we have to start your journey early. So for example, from Diskit to Pangong Lake, we started our journey early at 6 o'clock, and so we were able to manage it. Around 9 o'clock only we cross out that riverbed, that patch. Another risky point is there, that is from Pang to Kelong. So Pang to Kelong, here this route is there, from Leh to Manali. In that Pang to Kelong, certain these glacier patches are there. One glacier patch is somewhere around 50 meter in length. That means prior to that good road is available, after that good road is available, but in between that, this type of boulders and all that are there. We have to cross out that by sitting on bike only. Now say, trucks can pass out very easily through that patch. Traffic of trucks, even military vehicles are there. But when you are there on bike, we have to cross out these boulders, and maybe possible sometime fear is that our bike gets stuck out between that boulders. At that time, you have to just get it up. Take your foot in that water. We have to just get it up. Bike will move automatically. This is what somewhat practice is required, but this is not that risky. Okay, so only these patches are problematic. Otherwise, say, what is the problem? Urban people, they consider these roads are worst. So when I was there traveling from Dras to Leh, many tourists advised us that okay, you can go back from Leh to Srinagar only. Don't go by Leh to Manali road. It is not that proper. But when we observe, we find that it is very nice, because we travel even more mountains with more or say improper road only. So we find that it is very nicely built. Only certain patches were there where the road was not that good. That was under development. But otherwise, roads are very nice. I'm thanking once again to Indian Army and BRO for making our journey. Because of BRO only we can travel this all these things. Otherwise, this area was almost inaccessible. Try to find out in month of January and February this area. Roads are closed and then it is inaccessible. So this is the way we can go there. Don't fear about that roads because people are not that way ready. Say my psychology is something different. I want always smooth road. Then you may say that okay, road is not good. If only 10-20 kilometers patch is not good, then you can blame out entire road. It is not the situation. I am again telling that some patches are not yet made. Yet means in 2018. But maybe possible when you are travelling in 2019 or onwards, then you will find that the roads are perfect. What is inner line permit? So when you are travelling here from say Leh to Diskit, you are crossing out Khar Dungla. This area is under army control, and so we have to take permit from government over here. So permit is obtained from Leh, or otherwise another thing is there, you can apply online. Its facilities available online also. Just check out Leh inner line permit, and then you can get out permit online also. You have to pay some amount, and then you can get stamped copy. It is advisable to take at least 3-4 Xerox of each and every permit, because on that check post they are asking copy. So original copy they are observing, and Xerox they are keeping with them, and therefore it is advisable to take out always Xerox copy, more than 2-3 Xerox copies of each and every permit over this part you have to take. And don't forget to carry out your government approved ID, something like UID, that is Aadhaar card, or election voting card, driving license. Obviously your driving license is there with you, but like that, original ID proofs are required, because this area is under army, and at check post you have to show your ID proof and officially documents of all whatever bike you are carrying out, vehicle you are carrying out, official documents should be there with you. Insurance copy will also required at some point. So carry out your all documents with you. So ultimately, I am talking about my journey. We started our journey from Chandigarh at afternoon around 2 o'clock, and we went to Pathankot. This all area is on Indian plains. We were having halt at Pathankot and then started our journey on next day. The Jammu Kashmir is hilly area. When we entered in Jammu, after some time only, we went into hilly area and we went to Udhampur. Or area is hilly. We have to climb ups and ups and ups. Manasar is the nice place on the way where you can get good food, comparatively at cheaper rate, and quality food is there. Particularly in this range, you are getting very good pure vegetarian food. If you are consuming non-veg, then all right. But if you are having fond of only veg food like me, then I am suggesting you this area is nice. Then onwards, we went to Jawahar Tunnel. The road is under construction and therefore some more time was consumed. At Jawahar Tunnel, because it was season of Amarnath Yatra, the army were not, these people were not allowing us to go through Jawahar Tunnel at evening. So we were there around 6 o'clock. So we made a compulsory halt before Jawahar Tunnel. There are some huts. Say they are selling out Maggi, then eggs are there, and some other thing is also they are selling out along with cold drinks and all that. And they are giving you shelter simply. The place is having name as Shaitani Nala, and there they are giving you this type of facilities. 100 rupees per person they are taking. They are giving you pillow, blankets, like that, and shelter obviously. Toilet facility is not at all good there. It's very, very dirty. Common toilet was there, but outside also we are able to guess that what will be there inside. So that is the only problem. This is at public place, but there is army camp, and because of that we are feeling safety in this whole area. Army men are compulsorily marching over there. During night also they were there, and so we feel quite safe in this area. Think why unsafe we should feel. That is different issue, not of this. But we were there at Jawahar Tunnel at morning around 8 o'clock. They said that okay, you can go through tunnel now. And then we crossed that Jawahar Tunnel. Then we went to Srinagar. In Srinagar also, we got certain pure veg hotels. Vaishno Dhaba, that is there. From Srinagar, we travel to Dras. Now, on this road, we are getting most important place, that is Sonmark. After crossing Sonmark, the tourists are getting less in number. And then, only trekkers are there, and obviously, goods carriers, they were there. There is pass that is called as Jojila, where I faced first time problem of cold for a little. I am saying little because it was at evening we were there, around say 7 o'clock we were there at that Jojila, where the after sunset the cold was there, and then I used shoes over there. Till that I was on chappal only and half shirt, so I use my windsheater over there, monkey cap and shoes, then and hand gloves. Only that much was sufficient to break even that cold. And then we were at Dras. Dras is very nice city, a small town, but till that Kashmir Valley, that means from Jawahar Tunnel to that Jojila, we observed tremendous army. It is almost fair to say that we are crossing out all this highway through the protection of army only. Just wait at some point on the road, observe here and there on hill, you will find that at some point some gunman is there. So like that, protection is there. That means some insecurity problems are there, therefore these people are there for security of us. But once you cross Jojila, army checkposts are there, but no, this type of tight army is there. People are very, very cooperative. Particularly, I observed in Dras. We stayed night at Dras because we were there around 8 o'clock. So we stayed there at Dras. From Dras, there is a war memorial just 5 kilometers away from Dras towards Leh. many people wrongly calling this area as Kargil Memorial. This area, that means entire region, we are calling as Kargil region. But actually, Memorial is there at Dras. It is 5 km away, towards Kargil side obviously, at Dras. From Dras, that war memorial is there. You can observe the memories of war, in particularly that Kargil war. You can observe that memories, the documentary is shown, and then come out, you will observe that all hills, that Wagha hill and all that, they are showing over there. It's very nice thing that it is, we are maintaining, we means army is maintaining all these things, and people are very, very cooperative. Then we went to Kargil, but actually what that Kargil city is there, there is museum and all that, that things are not there. They are there at Dras only. At Kargil onwards, the journey is very nice. You can observe huge mountains, plains. Journey is really interesting. You have to get close to nature. Then onwards, the population changes. Till this region, Muslims are more, but then onwards people becoming more and more towards this side. And then we visited a place that is called as Lamayuru. We were having halt at Lamayuru. Very nice small town is there. Just beside that, they show a place that is called as Moonland, where all only sand and sand and sand that is there. This is resembling to Moonland. So that is called as part Moonland. Then our journey was there through huge mountains. And through mountains we were traveling. A fantastic road, well maintained by BRO. We are there. After that, we visited a place. I should call this as a cheating place. This is called as Magnetic Hill. So what I observed, that I am going to tell you. So Magnetic Hill, so we feel that there is no such thing. What the marks are there, and between mark you have to keep your vehicle, it will go down. Actually we can observe a gentle slope over there, and therefore it is happening. But they say that now road is widened, when originally the road was narrow at that time. At that time it was going above, anti-gravitically. But now they have changed the structure and all that, like that they are telling. But anyway, I feel personally that though there is such magnetic connection over there, many times it happens that gentle slope is there. But because of, say, surrounding, we are not able to guess that slope. And you may experience certain things that your vehicle is slowing down. But that is because of gentle slope is there for road. And with surrounding, you are not able to get down that gentle slope. So these things are there. Then we went to Leh. Here we have to make compulsory halt, because we have to take permits. And then you have to go. Now Leh is very nice place to stay. Just before Leh, there is again war memorial. You must visit that. A very nice place to visit. And you can spend nearly entire day if you want to observe it nicely. Otherwise, half an hour is sufficient. Just go, observe some pictures, observe some aircrafts, carry out your photography with tanks and come out. But actually, if you want to observe, it's time consuming, but it is a very nice thing to observe. From Leh, our journey started towards Diskit. Now here, from Lamayuru onwards, we were travelling on bank of river Indus. So Lamayuru to Leh journey was very nice. We were there on bank of river Indus. At one side mountain, at other side river Indus was there. And then we went to Leh. From Leh to Diskit Valley. Diskit Valley is on bank of river Shyok. Many people calling this as Nubra Valley, but Nubra Valley is different. Just you are there at bank of river Shyok. From front side, means I am facing towards west, then from west side a river comes that is called as Nubra. There is confluence of river Nubra and Shyok. So if you are going in Nubra Valley, then that means you are in Panamik. Whereas this is Shyok Valley. Khar Dungla is highest motorable road when it was built. About 5000 meter altitude this road is there, but exact altitude we also not know because two different boats were there of Indian Army only, but mentioning different heights. But anyway, it's very high motorable road and you can enjoy. Now in month of August we were enjoying snow covered peaks all around us at Khar Dungla. Then we have to get it down towards Shyok River. Our journey is very nice on the bank of Shyok River and ultimately in the bed of Shyok River. That road is fantastic. In that all wide bed, desert of Shyok River, we were traveling by a straight road for many minutes. Approximately 15 to 20 minute journey is there on that straight road. And then a marvelous place is there that is called as Diskit. That was there, a Buddhist monastery, a Maitreya Buddha idol, huge idol, and very nicely maintained monastery. There now residential hotels are also available, so you can stay there in monastery by paying whatever the charges. Along with that, a nice vegetarian hotel is also, restaurant is also available over there. So we stayed at that monastery and then we started our journey on next day towards Turtuk. So I was showing here Diskit. From Diskit onwards we started again westwards towards the place that is called as Turtuk. If you have sufficient time, then only go to Turtuk Valley. It's deep in the Karakoram mountain. Narrow valleys are there, and through that narrow valleys, journey is there along the bank of river Shyok. From Turtuk, we return back to Diskit again. 80 kilometer journey is there. Roads are nicely maintained. Comparatively wider roads are there, and you can go straightway to Diskit. And from Diskit, we made halt here somewhere. We were not at Diskit now. We started our journey. And there is one place that called as Agam. We were guided by some people that some hotels are there at Agam, you can make halt at Agam. So we started our journey. But at Agam practically only one hotel we found, but that was also closed. And at night we were not also able to locate out houses. So we were carrying out our tent and we made there a tent halt. Some people from Himachal Pradesh were also traveling. We met with them, they helped us to set up tent and all that. They were also having halt there on bank of Shyok River in that tent only. So they helped us and we were there at Agam. Next day we travelled towards Pangong Lake. So this journey is very nice. High up in the mountains we are there. And then we crossed out that glacier part. That was only risky part. So risky means somewhat difficult, but otherwise roads are very nice. Everywhere you find Himalaya in different form. So no doubt, only in the river beds, you can find out in that river area, only some vegetation, trees and all that. Otherwise entire something like desert only, but that is also having fantastic beauty. We travel through that and then ultimately, by crossing out checkpost at Durbuk, our journey was towards Chinese border this way. And then a fantastic Himalayan part we observed and reach at Pangong Lake, a deep blue color lake. Observe from height, you'll find that colors are continuously changing. At different place we are having different color. Even as daytime changes, colors of lake also changes. A really beautiful, heavenly lake I can call, that is Pangong Lake. at Pangong Lake. Very nice accommodation is available. We are calling that as tent accommodation. My suggestion is that please try to get some wooden tent over here instead of that cotton tent, because say there is problem of cold. Its temperature is very low at Pangong Lake, and around that you will find that all snow covered peaks. So in month of August also I was facing problem here of cold. I was having shoes at this place in my leg, as well as a sweater, wind sheeter, all things are required over here. It is too much of cold I observed in month of August, particularly other all part where I was traveling on my half shirt, but here it was not possible. It is really very very cold. Pangong Lake is very nice. Then we started our back journey on next day to Leh. So this way there is a pass that is called a Chang La. By crossing that pass we came to Karu and then went to Leh to make halt. Now as we were travelling by bike before entering in this area, so at Leh only we changed oil of bike, as well as we checked out our bike with mechanic that some problems are there or not, and rectified some problem like we have to make chain tight and all that. Brakes were tested. After returning this, again we tested our bike, and then we start our journey on next day from Leh to Manali. This journey is a really heavenly journey. Huge mountains. We are crossing of that mountains through different passes. Then long plains, actually plateaus. We cross out that plateaus and we stayed at Pang. We were not aware at that time that we are staying at such high altitude place, because Pang is having altitude more than 4000 meters. So even at greater height than Leh, and it is really a chilled one in month of August also. We started journey from Pang at early morning 5 o'clock. We stayed there, what is the biggest problem in this particular area? That villages are not there on road. And even accommodation facility is not also that way available. Around 40-50 kilometer distance you will find out some tents are there. So you can get some sort of place to live. But otherwise, you have to drive it continuously until you will get that place. So for example, after Leh, one pass we crossed, there some accommodation was there. From that onwards, till Pang, no accommodation was there. At Pang also, there is army camp at one side, and at other side, they were having some tents. Some local people were constructing out tent houses, and they will be serving us food also, a very nice food, and at comparatively very very cheap rate they are providing us. Even accommodation we got at around 150 rupees per person. At that rate they provided us accommodation. Personal tents are also there, as well as common tents are also there at Pang. Then from Pang we went to place that is called as Kelong. Here Kelong is very nice place to stay in deep mountain of Himalayas. You are staying at mid part of Himalaya. If you observe other side, you will have only high mountain. If you observe at lower side, only deep valley. And like that, accommodation is there at Kelong. From Kelong, another last pass we were there to cross, that is called as Rohtang Pass. It's very beautiful place in month of August also, because otherwise it is snow covered, but now in month of August it was open. And then we returned to Manali. Then onwards a city life, some sort of well populated highway was there. Actually from Kelong to Manali also highway was comparatively having good traffic, but from Manali to Chandigarh highway is densely trafficked highway, and we returned back to Chandigarh with one halt from Kelong, that is somewhere at Bilaspur we were having halt, and then we continued our journey till Chandigarh. Overall experience is very, very nice. Can common man go to this trip? Answer is yes. We were also common men. We were not that way trekkers. But we were able to complete our this trip. Only thing is that good mental strength is required. That's all. Other things, very, very easy.